I'm Aaron Humphrey. I'm a lecturer in Media and Digital Humanities here at the University of Adelaide. So I research and teach about digital communication and different ways that we can use digital technology to interact with other people.
I'm Alexis Tindall. I'm the Manager of Digital Innovation here at the University of Adelaide Library. I have a professional background in museums and collections, and one of the things that I really get excited about in digital humanities is the way that digital approaches and digitization can help us explore those collections in new ways and use them to help understand the past, present, and future.
So there's lots of ways to answer the question, what is digital humanities? But I think fundamentally it comes down to two things. On one hand, there's the use of digital tools and technologies, established and emerging methods, to answer traditional humanities questions. So things like, who are we? What is our community? How do we interact with each other? And on the other hand...
It's the application of critical thinking, traditionally the domain of humanities study, to new and emerging technologies, how they influence us, how they influence our community, our society, and how they set us up for the future.
So it really is that combination of technology and critical thinking that is sort of the area where digital humanities really functions and works best. There are a whole bunch of ways that we can approach digital humanities. What new technology has given us is a vast universe of data, things that have been digitized that have never been available before digitally. Huge data sets, information that's organized and accessible in ways that hasn't really ever been possible before. And so digital humanities is a way of kind of diving into that information, sorting through it, connecting data sets that haven't been connected before. So you get things like 3D scans of paintings that you can connect with geospatial data to say, where was this made? Who else was making paintings at that time? What did they look like? And being able to do things like network analysis to show how these things have been connected, how they have changed over time, and what that means for today. So it's a really exciting way to be able to answer questions using new methods. And it really is, I think, about kind of that interdisciplinary connection between different sorts of technologies. There's all kinds of ways this has been applied.
Yeah, so some of the interesting ways this has been applied is, say, looking at things like sentiment analysis to explore, say, historical diaries or letters, see what the words really say about how the participant or the writer felt about that incident either in their lives or that historical moment in time. Another application that's been really interesting is looking at things like health records or probate records or service records to look at the intergenerational impacts of things like poverty, imprisonment, convict transportation, and war. There's been some really interesting applications of virtual reality to enliven records of Indigenous knowledge, language, and country, and really embody that and create a very rich experience when exploring those areas of knowledge. And even looking at things like, say, the recommender algorithms that exist on social media and the way that they contribute to things like the spread of misinformation or the building of community and online communities in those sorts of spaces as well. So the University of Adelaide Library is really excited about supporting digital humanities. I mean, philosophically, the role of an academic library traditionally has been to provide resources to our students, our teachers, and our researchers to support their work. And in these times, that is more and more a digital activity than it ever has been before. So we have not only electronic journal collections, access to databases that people use in their research, we're also digitizing our own archives and our own special collections and material like that. And we very much understand that our role as a library is to help our community use these things to their best advantage. So that also involves supporting certain tools, whether they be open online tools, whether they be applications and programs that you install on the computer, or whether they be vendor subscribed tools and things like that. So the ways that this actually happens, the way the University Library is supporting digital humanities at the moment, is a range of activities, including creating some online material, looking at how our special collections and our digital collections support humanities research and teaching, and thinking about events and things like that. So.
Yeah, one of the really exciting things that we're doing is kind of collaborating between the library and the Faculty of Arts to create this digital humanities lab program that we've been working on together. Mm-hmm. So getting researchers in from different parts of the university to talk about how they use digital tools, and getting people in from the outside to kind of do training to support students and our researchers to be able to kind of be there on the cutting edge of new kinds of digital technologies, which has been really exciting. Well, look, where would somebody go, Alexis, if they wanted to find more information about the kinds of programs that we offer at the university?
Yeah, so the University Library is building an online space with a range of materials to support digital humanities research, both some descriptions and access points for entry-level tools, as well as some showcases of some of the research that we are delivering here at the university. And if they were interested in entering your digital humanities undergraduate, where would they find information about that?
Well, there's information on the Faculty of Arts website, so students can enroll in the major right now, and there's the course guide is online, so students should be able to find that on the university website and read about the exciting courses that we have on offer and see when they can enroll.